Dear children, good morning and welcome to this session. Did you read the portion which we explained? Yes, we came across two characters. Who are they? Yes, they are the great musician Tenzin and the Emperor Akbar. Tenzin introduced another great musician. Who is he? Yes, that is his guru. The Emperor planned to go and meet the guru at his home. So Tenzin agreed with the emperor's wish, but he put forward a request. What was that? Yes, the emperor should not go there as an emperor. Then the king agreed and he said he will go as a humble lover of music. Let's see what happens next. Sandhya Haridas was the man Tenzin had spoken of. He had been Tenzin's music teacher and he lived the austere life of a hermit. When Tenzin and the emperor reached his hut, he was busy with his daily course. When they asked him to sing, he smiled but said firmly, "I am long past the age for singing." Even his favorite people could not persuade him to change his mind. Listen, children. Here we could see another character. He is the guru, Tenzin's music teacher. What is his name? Yes, it is Sandhya Haridas. He had been Tenzin's music teacher and he lived the austere life of a hermit. He led the life of an austere life. That means very simple and not a comfort life. Hermit means a priest or a sannyasi. Okay. We already know that Tenzin and the emperor already started their journey. When they reached in the hut, hut means a small house of the hermit or this Haridas. Okay. Then they reached in the hut. He was busy with his daily course. Course means job, daily activities. Who was busy? Yeah, Sandhya Haridas was busy. When they asked him to sing, he replied firmly but in smile. What did he reply? Yes, for him, he is too old to sing. Even his favorite people could not persuade him to change his mind. Even his student, that is Tenzin, also could not change his mind. Whose mind? Yeah, the Sandhya Haridas' mind. Let's see the next paragraph. But Tenzin knew how to get around him. He offered to sing before his guru and he made a deliberate mistake. "That is not the right note, Tenzin," cried his teacher, amazed. "What has happened to you?" See, dear children, now you know how the teacher can make speak by, you know, if you are, they are the teachers and between you, if having some problems, the teacher is not at all talking with you, you may use the trick. The same way, Tenzin used a trick here. He behaved like an obedient child and offered to sing a song before him. Then what did he do? Yeah, it is said like this. He deliberately or purposely make a mistake. Suddenly, what happened? The guru must clear it, isn't it? So the clear wants to just justify the mistake. The guru was amazed. Why he amazed? Yes, he knew that his student made the mistake. And he is a very good musician and he made the mistake. Then he asked, what did he say? "That is not the right answer, Tenzin. The right note, and Tenzin. What happened to you? This is not the way, Tenzin. Play the note." He understood that guru may start talk, isn't it? Let's see what happened next. Tenzin did not seem to understand his teacher. He made the same mistake again. Exasperated, Sandharidas took the tambura from Tansen's hands and sang the right note. Then he went on to the next and the next. See, Tansen repeated the same mistake again and again without understanding what his guru said. He pretending, okay? We know that he is pretending and his aim was to get around his guru. Guru could not control himself and he took the tambura from him and sang in a right way. Then one by one he started his singing. Let's see the next paragraph. The melody of his voice spread across the forest like the first glimmer of dawn or the fragrance of jasmine. Both Akbar and Tansen listened to him as if they were hypnotized. And the emperor realized that Tansen had spoken the truth. He had not known that music could be like this. He had certainly never heard anything like it before. See, his melodious voice, with his sweet voice, spread all over the forest. How it is compared here? Yeah, like the first morning ray of the sun. Or just like the fragrance of the jasmine, his voice spread everywhere in the forest. Akbar and Tansen were listening the music. They felt some magic spell there. Now the emperor realized or understood what Tansen said was true. He had never been listened such a great music in his life. Dear children, I hope it is clear to you. We'll stop here. We'll continue with the next session. Thank you.